Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to go over everything you need to know about crop marks or trim marks and bleeds. First, I'll show you what they are, and then I'll show you how to set them up in all three major graphic design programs, Adobe Illustrator, InDesign, and Photoshop. All right, let's get started. Okay, I printed out this sheet to show you how crop marks and bleeds kind of work. So these right here, these little marks are crop marks, and they show a printer where to cut the design. So if we lay this right on here like this and line it up with both crop marks, then I can use my X-Acto knife to cut right here along the crop marks and then cut along here too. This top design is set up with bleeds, so there's a lot of overhang. Bleed is kind of an overhang so that if you cut along the crop marks, you don't have to be exactly perfect. You can mess up a little and still not have a little bit of white after it's cut. But down here, I've got it set up with no bleeds. So if we line this up perfectly with the crop marks, you can kind of see if I come over here, that we're right on the very edge of the design. So if I try to cut this now, there's a good chance I'm gonna mess up and include some of this white, and we definitely don't want that. So that's why you want to include crop marks and bleeds when you have part of the design going to the edge. Now, I just drew this on a piece of paper, but if this was my design and I was gonna cut it here and here, I would need not only crop marks, because this is just a 3x5 piece of paper, I would also need bleeds to go all the way around because of this part right here. So even though it just goes off the one edge, we'll have to put bleeds all the way around. So I would put an eighth of an inch here, an eighth of an inch here, an eighth and an eighth, or 3 millimeters on each side. And of course, we would have to extend this line down to touch that eighth of an inch, which would be right about here. Now, here's a design that I got in the mail the other day that does not include bleeds at all. So this is not a normal size. So when I unfold it like this, I can see that it's been cut, so it would need crop marks, but there's no part of the design at all in this whole mailer that goes off of the edge of the page. So this was a design decision by the graphic designer. Maybe they just didn't want to deal with bleeds for some reason, or they just think it looks nice, which it does, without bleeds. But this would still need crop marks because it'll get printed on a standard size and then cut down to whatever this is. It's probably like 8.5 by 17 or something like that. If you're using a standard sheet of paper and you don't want to deal with crops and bleeds, then you can set it up something like this. This is an 11 by 17, which is a standard size here in the US. It's kind of like letter 8.5 by 11, but it's twice that big. This is a page in my portfolio, and I didn't want to deal with, you know, having to cut a bunch of portfolio pages because of bleeds. So I made sure nothing went off the edge on any side. Now, if I decided to extend her legs off the edge, I would have to put crops and bleeds on all four sides and then print it on a larger size, which the one up from this is 12 by 18, and then cut it down along the crop marks to 11 by 17. All right, now that you understand a little more about crops and bleeds, let's head over to Illustrator and I'll show you how to set your document up to include these. It automatically makes them for you, so it's pretty cool. Okay, so I'm here in Illustrator, and this is the design that I want to print. Now, this is an 8.5 by 11 inch sheet of paper, which is a standard size here in the US, but we do have this bar butting up exactly on the edge. And when we have something like that, we're going to need bleeds. And this also means that we cannot print this on an 8.5 by 11. It has to go up a size. So you probably have to put it on an 11 by 17. To set up bleeds, I'm going to come up here to File, Document Setup, and then the bleeds are right here. And then my units here are points. I'm going to change those to inches, and I'll put 0.125, and it'll automatically update across all four edges. And that's because I have this little lock locked. So it's a good idea to always have this locked. I've never come across in 20 years of being a graphic designer when you don't have your bleed on all four sides. Technically, because there's no bleed on the other three, you could just put this on the left, but I don't really know anyone who does that. Everybody just does all four sides. So we'll say okay. And now when we zoom in here, we can see this little red, and actually it's kind of white right now, this line out here. So we need to extend our artwork to touch that line. So I'll select this bar and I'm just gonna pull this over like this. So nothing has changed over here. I'm not moving it. I'm just extending the bar so that it touches the bleed mark right here. Bleeds you can set up right here in your document, but you'll set up crop marks when you're saving as a PDF. PDF is really the standard for printing these days, so I always provide the printer with a print-ready PDF. So to do that, we'll go to File, Save As. I'm going to change my format to Adobe PDF. I'll click Save. Here is where we can add marks and bleeds. So I'm going to click right over here. I'm going to add trim marks. I don't need any of these other printer marks, but the trim mark weight, I always keep it at the default, which is 0.25 points. And then the offset is 0.0833 inches. And these have always worked very well for me. You'll want to check use document bleed settings because we did set those up right here. But if you haven't set those up, in your document, you could potentially do that right here and it automatically include those. But we already have them set up. I'll use document bleed settings and save PDF. And now I'll open the PDF I just made. And you can see that crop mark is coming right down here. And so we have an eighth of an inch bleed leeway in our document now. Now, if we hover in the lower left corner, we can see the size of our document is now 9.42 by 11.92. It's not 8.5 by 11 anymore. And that makes sense because we've added space for our crop marks. The cut size will be 8.5 by 11 if we cut right along here and right along here. Okay, now we'll head on over to InDesign and I'll show you how to do it there. Okay, so here's our document in InDesign. Now this is also an 8.5 by 11 document, but as you can see, we've got something touching the edge. So we need bleeds and crops here. So I'm gonna go to File, Document Setup, it's very similar, and then add the bleed right here. I'm gonna add 0.125 inches. And because my little lock is checked, it automatically populates all four of them. And we'll say okay. Now nothing seems to have changed, but if you hit W on your keyboard, you'll be able to see a different view of InDesign. You might already have that view on, but you can see that bleed line and you can see that our picture doesn't touch the bleed line yet. So I'm going to just extend it like this. Now when I do that, you'll see that it didn't actually extend the picture because the picture stops right here. I'm extending the frame when I do that. So we have a few options here. We can hit A on our keyboard to get to the direct selection tool. I can select that image inside the frame and then get on the corner and make it bigger. So this does change your layout over here. If you don't want to do that, I'll hit Command Z or Control Z to undo. We'll want to actually extend this image in Photoshop. And I'll quickly show you how to do that. And Photoshop beta just recently included something called generative fill, where it'll try to look at your whole picture and then make its best guess as to what should be over here. So I'll show you that first. Unfortunately, generative fill cannot be used for commercial use right now. So keep that in mind. This might not be the way you want to go about it. And I got my image from Pexels. I'm just going to pull it into Photoshop beta. And now I'll hit C to get on my crop tool. And I'm just going to pull this more than an eighth of an inch out so that there's a little white space showing. I'm going to get it on my marquee tool and just draw around the piece that I want it to fill. And then automatically this generative fill bar will pop up. If I'm just wanting to fill it, I don't even have to enter anything here. I can click it and then hit generate. And it'll take a second, but now it's added pixels based on the rest of the photo, and this looks really great. So that is one way to do it. Now, if you don't want to use generative fill because you can't use it for commercial purposes, I'll show you a different way. So I'm going to undo back to this point. And the other way of doing this is to draw a marquee around the stretchable part of the image. So this might be a very small little bit, but this whole thing is stretchable. I don't think you can stretch trees very easily without it being obvious. So what I'm going to do is hit Command T or Control T on a PC, get on the edge here and just stretch it over. Now it might actually make it bigger. You don't want that. So hold Shift and just stretch it over. And now when we look at this, yes, it has been stretched, but it is very, very hard to tell. And now our image is just a little bit longer. I'm gonna go ahead and go back to InDesign, and I'm just gonna draw a guide right where the left part of that palm tree is, so I know exactly where it is. And then I'll come back to Photoshop and save this. I'm gonna go ahead and go back to InDesign. I'll come over to my links panel. And by the way, if you're not seeing some of these panels, they'll be in window. So window links is right here. And you'll see this little yellow warning box. That's because we updated this picture just now in Photoshop. So I'm gonna click on the hamburger menu and just choose update link. Okay, and now it's kind of moved everything because it added this little bit. It actually sort of reduced everything because I added that. So I'm gonna get back on the image part, not the frame, but the image, and just click and drag it so that it goes all the way out. And now this is almost lined up. Maybe I can pull it a little further to get it lined up exactly right here. So this is pretty much in the same position that it was before. And if you wanna see how this looks without all of this stuff and without the bleed showing like that, you can hit W on your keyboard to get this view. I'll hit W to get back. Okay, so now let's export this. We'll go to File, Export, and I'll choose Adobe PDF for print right here, and I'll save it. I usually start out with press quality at the top, and then I come down here to marks and bleeds, and we'll do the same thing we did in Illustrator, which is crop marks and use document bleed settings, which is 0.125 inches, 3 millimeters, or 9 points. Okay, so we'll say Export. And it's telling me there's overset text, which is fine. Normally I would, you know, fix that, but this is just a tutorial, so I'm not worried about it. I'll say okay. And now let's take a look at the PDF. Okay, so we've got our crop marks here. We've got a bleed here. I'm just gonna draw a box on here so you can see where those crop marks are going to cut. So you can see that our bleed is working well. We have a lot of overhang in case we miss that cut. We have a lot of room for error. And this is also a lot bigger. It's 9.08 by 11.58 inches instead of 8.5 by 11. So we'll have to print this like on 11 by 17 or something like that and cut it down. All right, now let's go to Photoshop. Now Photoshop works a little bit differently. It's not quite as automatic. So I'll show you how it works. Now here's the design that I want to print at 5 by 3 inches. And you might think that we don't need bleeds here, but this isn't actual white. So if we put it up against white, it'll be like kind of grayish. So we would need bleeds in this case because it's part of the photo. So I'm going to close this and I'll start a new document. I'm going to make it 5 by 3. We'll want our resolution to be 300. I'm going to go with RGB color because I'll probably be printing this with a Xerox printer, which is a digital press, and RGB is good for those. So we'll create. And now this is our cut size, 5 by 3. So we need to add bleeds to this. We're going to add 1/8 of an inch to each side, but before we do that, we want guides so that we can see where our cut size is. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a new layer. Same thing with this, all your panels over here, if you're not seeing them, are going to be under window. Then I'll hit D on my keyboard, and that'll bring black to the foreground. I'm going to fill this layer with black, and to do that, I'm going to hit Option Delete or Alt Delete on a PC. So what you're doing is filling the whole layer with the foreground color, which is black. It doesn't actually matter what color it is, but it needs to be fully filled. Now we'll come up here to View, Guides, and New Guides from Shape. Okay, so now we've added guides so we can see where the cut size is of this document. And I'm gonna delete that layer because we don't need it anymore. Now we'll go to Image, Canvas Size, and I'm gonna make sure Relative is checked. I'm going to add 1/4 inch to the width and 1/4 inch to the height. So that is actually 1/8 and 1/8, which equals 1/4 and 1/8 and 1/8, which equals 1/4. And that's why it's 1/4 instead of 1/8 here. We'll want to make sure the anchor is in the middle, and then we'll say okay. Now we can see the bleeds outside the guides, and the guides is where it will cut. Next we'll place our design. So I'll go to File and Place Linked, and here's our document. Now I don't have a whole lot of room here on the top, and I want a little more space like this. So I'm going to hold Shift and come in from the corner and just make this a little bit smaller. And then I'm going to center this up. You can see the difference here between the white of the background and the actual white. I'm going to need to extend this part, and the top to get it to extend all the way out to our bleeds. So I'm gonna hit M on my keyboard to get to my rectangle marquee tool. And then I'll draw around the stretchable part of this image, which is just this white area, and hit Command T. Well, I was going to hit Command T, but I cannot do this because this is a linked file. So I'm gonna right click and choose Rasterize Layer right down here. Now I'll hit Command T, and now I have the ability to stretch this. I'm gonna do the same thing right here. I have very little space to do this without touching part of my mockup, but it'll probably be fine. And then I'll also do it over here. So now our image goes out to the bleed in all four areas. Next, we'll go to File, Print, and this is where we can add our crop marks. Now, if you don't have a printer set up at all, you'll have to use a virtual printer and you'll have to set that up. But it's really handy because it means that you can save as a PDF from any program. If you don't know how to do that, there'll be a video at the top of your screen that shows you that process. It's really simple. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and choose my virtual printer. And I'm gonna scroll down here until we get to Printing Marks and Functions. We want corner crop marks, and you can see them there, but this doesn't have the bleed yet. That's just the cut marks. So we'll want bleed right here. And then we'll put in 0.125 inches and we'll say okay. And now you can see it's inset and ready to cut. Then we'll come down here to print. We'll say okay. Instead of actually hitting print, we'll go to PDF right here and choose save as PDF. And then I'm gonna call this Photoshop. And our title will be Photoshop 2. Then we'll save. And now if we go and open that file, we can see crop marks and bleeds on our photo. Looks like I didn't quite get this part just right, but anyway, you get the idea. All right, I hope this video has been helpful for you. If you're still having trouble with bleeds and crops, or if you just have a question about it, please leave a comment in the comment section below and I'll try to answer you as soon as possible. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.